Hi, I'm Dr. David Hill, and today we're going to be talking about concerns many parents have with infants' exposure to soy formula. Now, obviously, the best thing you can feed an infant is breast milk, but that's not possible for everybody for a variety of reasons. Soy formulas have been available for almost 100 years now, and they currently account for up to 25% of the U.S. market share for formulas. There are not that many indications for soy formula specifically, so that market share is probably a little higher than a lot of pediatricians think it should be. Parents are most often concerned with the presence of isoflavones in soy formulas. These are chemicals that are present in many beans, and especially high in soybeans, that mimic the action of the hormone estrogen in the human body. Parents are worried that since isoflavones can mimic estrogen, is it possible that they'll lead to some abnormality of their child's sexual development or reproductive organs, or will they lead to some sort of tumor like breast cancer? The good news here is that isoflavone levels consumed by babies who take soy formula don't seem to have any demonstrable effect. There have been no clinical studies that have been able to show any problems with isoflavones in infants. Another issue parents are concerned about is aluminum. Soy formula contains 100 to 500 times as much aluminum as human breast milk or even cow's milk formula. And some people are concerned, could that cause problems with bone growth? So far, no studies have shown that the amount of aluminum consumed by babies who take soy formula are problematic for their growth and development. There are, however, two lesser known and less common problems with soy formula. One has to do with the rare baby who's taking medication for low thyroid. We test all babies at birth for thyroid disease, and very few of them actually have it. But if your baby is one of the few who's taking thyroid medication, you should probably avoid soy formula. It can interfere with absorption of the medicine. The other babies who should not have soy formula are those who are born premature or very low birth weight. Those babies don't seem to develop very healthy bones when they're taking soy protein, so we recommend milk protein-based or hydrolyzed formulas for those babies. To review, soy formula has 25% of the current market share, even though there are not that many reasons to use it. Isoflavones, estrogen-like chemicals in soy formula, don't seem to be dangerous to babies at the levels that are present, nor does aluminum. On the other hand, if your baby has thyroid disease or was premature or very low birth weight, you should probably find a different formula. Talking about soy formula concerns, I am Dr. David Hill.